Certified, the most accurate in Central Kentucky.
Thanks for staying with us. We're now joined by Chief Meteorologist Jason Myers. And Jason, I'm going to blame you.
Not happy, right?
It's really cold outside.
It is. I was enjoying the upper 70s we had this past weekend. It was really nice to be outside. We had Keeneland going on, a lot of fall activity as well. Yeah.
I was struck tonight by the wind.
Yes.
That's what I really noticed.
It does make it feel much cooler at times. We've had sustained winds around 20 miles per hour, so that makes it feel even colder. And it's unfortunate. I mean, we were due for some cooler weather. We've had above average temperatures. Now we're dealing with the rain and the chilly temperatures. Live HD radar showing right now we're seeing a little bit more scattered activity, and most of the activity is to the west of I-75, but we've had these showers kind of rotating through the area, kind of a counterclockwise rotation across the region here. The showers that are developing to our west as part of a second cold front is heading in our direction, so that's just going to bring another reinforcing shot of some colder air to our area. But here on live HD radar, again, just showing some light rain across the region. It's been a good soaking rain, though, for many locations, especially across parts of eastern Kentucky, about 1¾ inches for Knott County at the Kentucky Mesonet site, Breathitt County, right around 1½ inches, about 1¼ inches for Rowan County, Madison County, over 1 inch, a little bit more than 3/4 of an inch, just under 1 inch as well for Fayette County at the Kentucky Mesonet site, and Franklin County picking up over 1/2 inch of rain. Fort Banks Skyview here from EKU's campus, and you can see just the camera lens there, just kind of covered with rain at this time. So even if it's not significant rain, it's a little bit more of a mist, and yes, just not great weather to be outside. Lingering showers, though, will stay around for Tuesday, as well as the cooler temperatures, so you'll need the jacket and the rain gear Tuesday. And then later this week, we're talking about the potential for a frost and at times maybe even a freeze as we continue throughout our 7-day forecast. We'll detail that, and we do have more rain chances and, yes, even colder temperatures to talk about with your 7-day forecast as well. Temperatures outside right now, 51 in Lexington, 50 degrees in Richmond, as well as for Somerset, 49 for Monticello. Most of us, though, in the lower 50s, Jackson at 53. You can see sustained winds have calmed down somewhat, but still seeing wind gusts at least up around 20 miles per hour at times. Sustained winds about 5 to 15 miles per hour, mainly out of the west. Tomorrow morning, we start off in the mid-40s for your early morning jog. We'll see our sunrise just before 8 o'clock. Temperatures will start off chilly, but a cool afternoon. Highs only at 56 degrees, lower 50s into the evening hours. Satellite and radar showing the showers moving through. Our first cold front has already moved through. That brought with it noticeably cooler temperatures this evening. The second cold front, that's going to move through into the early morning hours. In fact, you can see that here on our future cast. The showers here just to our west. We even just talked about those showers. Notice how they rotate through during our early morning hours. So we'll have some rain here right around the morning commute. As we head into the afternoon, there could be some breaks of seeing just a little blue sky or a little sunshine, but most of the afternoon will feature mostly cloudy skies. Here at 5 o'clock, though, because it just shows some clearing for southeast Kentucky with some spotty rain still across northern Kentucky. So again, times you may see a little blue sky, but often on showers possible throughout your Tuesday. Temperatures only in the mid-50s, and then even colder for Wednesday. Wednesday morning, we start off in the upper 30s. We could even have some frost in the morning. Headed into the afternoon, a high temperature of 50 degrees. That means most of the afternoon temperatures are going to be staying in the 40s. For tonight, 46 degrees for the low temperature. Scattered rain showers chilly tonight. Tuesday, it stays cool throughout the afternoon. 56 degrees, more often on rain showers possible. 7-day forecast shows as we head into tomorrow, mid-50s, but cooler for Wednesday. Notice Wednesday and Thursday morning, temperatures start off in the upper 30s. More sunshine and pleasant for Thursday, and then another chance for rain late Friday, which could mess up those high school football games into the start of our weekend. In fact, Saturday's high temperature, 48 degrees. That's the coolest of the 7-day forecast. So at least that 65 on Thursday, it looks really nice maybe to head out to Keeneland on that day.
Okay, I take it back. We don't blame you. But isn't that the easiest thing to do, is to blame the meteorologist?
We can't control it. Sorry.
Yeah, right. Remember, they're just in marketing, not production.
If we could control it, we'd have 70s, or at least I would.
Okay, we like that. Thanks, Jason. More news.